Coming up, we look at updates to Windows Admin Center and Windows Server 2019 that light up practical hybrid management scenarios with Microsoft Azure, starting with Azure File Sync to sync your local files to the cloud for virtually unlimited storage with fast and secure access, Azure Network Adapter for streamlined and encrypted connectivity from your Windows Server environment to Azure using your existing hardware, and how you can now easily protect and failover your virtual machines to Azure. I'm joined once again by Jeff Woolsey. Welcome back to the show.
It's great to be back.
Now, on our last show, we covered some major enhancements in Windows Server 2019, and if you missed it, you can check out that show at the link shown. Now, one of the things you highlighted is how Windows Admin Center is the new management plane for Windows Server. That's only one aspect of Admin Center. It also enables hybrid scenarios as well.
It sure does. Windows Admin Center makes it much easier for you to take advantage of safe, practical, and secure ways to leverage the cloud with Azure. It's built for hybrid management, giving you a single pane of glass to discover Azure services from networking to security and much more. In addition, you can leverage Azure for critical everyday scenarios such as file storage, backup, server replication, and disaster recovery.
Okay, great. So I know that we have got a packed show here, so let's make it real for people. Would you agree that the number one use for a server is to share files?
Yes. It's the number one scenario for a server. In fact, file servers, they're ubiquitous.
So our viewers are likely going to know what a headache it is to ensure that there's enough storage capacity for their organization. If you think about it, how many times have you had to send out those please delete your old files emails? So what are we going to do to help there?
Matt, I could not agree more. We asked many of you about your file server pain points and heard that there's never enough capacity.
Which isn't surprising because users just tend to leave their stuff on file shares forever.
Yes. And purchasing more and more storage with no end in sight is really a costly proposition. And finally, people struggle with the need for better and easier data sharing across sites. So we developed Azure File Sync to address these challenges and more. So let's say I have a file server in Seattle. When I purchased it, I thought, 20 terabytes, that's going to be plenty. Well, now my storage is getting low. And before, I would have to purchase and add more hardware. Instead, we can set up Azure File Sync, which allows us to tier the least used files to cloud. What this means is that all of the data being used, really the hot data, that stays local, while the data that hasn't been touched transparently tiers up to Azure. This provides virtually bottomless storage, and your file server becomes a hot cache.
Okay, so how did you set this up? Can you show us?
Absolutely. So setup is naturally done through the Azure File Sync tool in Admin Center. You can see we've done some really cool things here. So let's go ahead and click on the Setup button. And this begins the setup process, which walks you through the process step by step. Now you can see that this server does not have the Azure File Sync agent installed. So let's go ahead and click on the Next button. And here you can see the installation directory and configure this option to update this agent via Microsoft Update. Now if you use a proxy in your environment, we support that as well. In this case, I'm going to leave everything as is, and I'm just going to click to deploy the agent. Now, right now, in just a couple of clicks, we're installing the Azure File Sync agent on the file server, all remotely from a Windows 10 system. While that continues, let's go ahead and switch to this other file server, just like this, and you can see that the Azure File Sync agent is already installed on this server. Now, notice it provides the installed and latest versions for your convenience. So let's go ahead and click on the Next button to configure our subscription information, the resource group, the storage sync service. Now give me 1 second while we go ahead and adjust the resource group, just like that. So let's go ahead and click Next to take us to the next step, which is to register the file server, your on-premises file server, with the Azure Storage Sync service. So let's go ahead and click on the Register Server button, where it will take a few moments to establish the trust relationship between these resources. And you can see the process is done. The button will turn into a finish button to let you know that the whole process is complete.
This is awesome, Jeff, and so easy, but let's just recap what happened. On your Windows 10 system, without RDPing into a server, you just deployed the Azure File Sync agent on a file server remotely, configured the storage sync service with your Azure subscription info, and registered the file server with the Azure Storage Sync service.
Yes.
All from Admin Center.
Yes, and there's more. So you can see Azure File Sync configured for this file server. You can see the installed server agent version, as well as the latest version available. So I know at a glance, I'm all set. Now, because we just configured this server, I don't have any shares synced. So I'm going to go ahead and click to the next tab where I have a file server already configured, and now you can see the larger picture. Again, we have the local agent info, and we can immediately see it's up to date. We can see the Azure storage subscription we're synced to. We have a link to the Azure portal for this registered server, along with any docs you need for reference. Now, if you look below at the server endpoints, we can see all the file shares synced to Azure, whether cloud tiering is enabled, and what the cloud tiering policy is, for example, 20%. Finally, if you want to see a specific sync group in Azure, all I have to do is click on the sync group, and it takes you to the exact right spot in Azure.
Awesome. I love that integration between on-premises and Azure, and this is a great solution for your storage needs, and we can stop sending out those nagging emails, please delete your files, etc. How does this solve for sharing between locations?
The great thing about Azure File Sync is when you sync your file server to the cloud, it provides the ability to sync across all your branch offices. So my files that I saved to the file share in Seattle, they get uploaded via Azure File Sync and shared to my offices in New York or Tokyo, for example.
Okay, but what if I've got apps running in Azure and I need to access the data in those synced file shares in branch offices? How does that work? Do the apps in Azure have to access the on-premises network?
Well, that's where the advantage of direct cloud access comes into play. Let's say you have some Azure PaaS services or IaaS VMs that need access to data on a synced file share. Because everything already resides in Azure, you can access the data in Azure and don't need to use up precious network bandwidth going all the way back down to the branch office.
So this all sounds awesome, but speaking of branch offices, what about networking? What about those smaller branch offices where you want to securely access Azure resources, but might not want to buy a bunch of extra networking hardware? Do we have anything to help there?
Yes. Now, ideally, you'd set up a secure point-to-site VPN, and that's exactly what we've done with the Azure Virtual Network Adapter. Before Windows Admin Center, you'd need to spend money and purchase a hardware appliance to create a secure tunnel, or you could try to configure this in software. Well, honestly, this was an arduous process to set up. Our guidance amassed dozens of pages of documents. You had to do things like create the gateway subnet, create an Azure public IP, figure out the client address space, create the Azure Virtual Network Gateway, create certificates, obtain public key file for the root certificate, et cetera, and the list goes on. Then, of course, you had to download and configure the VPN client.
Yep, I've actually done this, and it's a huge amount of work.
I'm sorry, by the way. So look, it took a networking expert on my team about 90 minutes. This guy knows networking in and out. It took him about 90 minutes to set this up without Admin Center, and we knew we could make this much easier. So let me show you how easy it is to create an encrypted network to Azure, all using your existing hardware with the Azure Network Adapter. So here's one of my servers, and I'm going to go ahead and click here to launch a PowerShell console to try and access an Azure IP address. I'm going to go ahead and paste in 172.17.3.4. I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to ping this server right now, and you'll see, the request timed out. So you can see this server doesn't have access to my resources in Azure. So I'm going to go ahead and leave the PowerShell console and go to the network tool where I have a new option to add the Azure Network Adapter. Now I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to select my network adapter and click Add Azure Network Adapter. Now, once I do that, I have the option to put in our subscription information, put in our location information, for example, the Western US, and we're going to attach it to our virtual network. That's it. Matt, something that took once 90 minutes in 4 clicks. So now we're going to click Create. This is the 5th one, and we've created this point-to-site VPN. And so we're going to go ahead, click Confirmation, we're connecting, and just like that, we're connected to Azure. And to prove it, I'm going to go back to the PowerShell console and ping that same IP address running in Azure. This time, you can see we have access securely through VPN, just like that. I did all this in software in less than 60 seconds and all through Windows Admin Center.
This is great stuff. So you can configure a Windows Server instance to securely access Azure resources from anywhere without the need to set up new hardware. And this new point-to-site VPN is great for small, remote branch offices that need Azure access. But would you use this solution to connect many servers?
So Azure Network Adapter right now is currently a point-to-site solution. However, between you, me, and our mechanics viewers, I'll let you know that we're working on a site-to-site solution for larger deployments where you want to have multiple servers share the same secure VPN to Azure.
Awesome. So let's switch gears and discuss backup. Now, in the data center, many customers are still using tape. And in remote and branch offices, backup coverage can be a little bit spotty. So what's going on in this space?
There's a lot going on in this space, Matt. We want to help you better protect your on-premises investments and take advantage of virtually unlimited storage in the cloud with Azure Backup.
Cool, can we take a look?
Absolutely. So with Backup, you want to set it and confidently know that it's protecting your data. Here's a server with Azure Backup configured. Now, because I'm using Azure's virtually unlimited storage, I don't need to deal with tape or running out of capacity. Now, at the top, I see my Azure subscription info. I see the latest backup status, the next scheduled backup, and whether I'm up to date. Next, you can see the job status and the number of recovery points, including the option below to backup right now.
But if backups are scheduled, why would I need an option to backup now?
Good question. Well, most of the time, you probably don't. But suppose you're about to perform a big app upgrade and want to have one more insurance policy. Well, simply click on Backup Now, and it will start an immediate backup. Now let me show you what this looks like in Azure. So by clicking on a smart link here, it takes me directly to the Azure Backup Vault and to the backup dashboard.
Cool. So we've seen Azure File Sync and now Azure Backup integration. What about server replication and disaster recovery?
Great point, Matt. Azure Site Recovery replaces the need for you to create your own secondary sites in order to replicate servers for business continuity, and we want to make it as easy as possible. Previously, setting this up took many steps and some PowerShell. This can be a little overwhelming, to say the least. The good news is we've made VM replication to Azure a lot easier, all with Admin Center. So let me show you the process now. Here, I have a number of VMs running Windows Server 2019, 2016, 2012, all the way back to Windows Server 2008. So let's take a look at this HR server running Windows Server 2008. I want to protect this VM by replicating it to Azure. Simply select the VM, click on More, and click on Protect VM. That's it. If I click Protect VM, it will begin replicating up to Azure. Now, if you look at the next VM in this list, this LOB inventory VM, it is running Windows Server 2008 R2 and is already protected. Notice there's a smart link to the side that says protected. When I click on the smart link, it takes me to the exact right location where this VM is replicated to Azure. So now, if my on-premises server dies, all I have to do is click on this planned failover button, and this VM will immediately start running in Azure. Now that the VM is running in Azure, you have options. You can keep them running in Azure if you want and take advantage of the fact that we're providing an additional 3 years of security updates for Windows Server and SQL Server 2008, 2008 R2 if you're running in Azure at no cost. And if you still decide you want to run this on-premises because you're running a workload that needs to access devices in your local environment, you still have that option too. Just set up your new server and click on Reverse Replication.
Great stuff, Jeff. Now, you've shown a bunch of new hybrid capabilities, the new Azure File Sync, the new Azure Network Adapter, and easy VM replication with just a few clicks. All great hybrid management scenarios. So how can folks get started and learn more?
First, evaluate Windows Server 2019. We have a trial available at the link shown. And while you're evaluating Windows Server 2019, standardize on Windows Server 2016 as your standard OS. It's the fastest growing Windows Server OS in Microsoft history, and Microsoft provides industry-leading security, hyper-converged infrastructure, hybrid cloud, and more. Finally, of course, adopt Windows Admin Center. Every demo you saw today was in Admin Center. All new server GUI investments are happening here, and it's the hub for our hybrid cloud integration. Furthermore, it's part of your Windows license, so it's a free download.
Awesome. Thanks, Jeff. And of course, subscribe and keep watching Microsoft Mechanics for the latest tech updates. See you next time.